it seems that something has erupted in America. For the last few weeks, there have been protests in cities across America calling for justice for George Floyd, Ahmaud Arbery, Breonna Taylor, an end to police brutality, and the wholesale dismantling of systemic racism in this country. And while we've had protests and calls for justice in the past, this time it seems different.
In Minneapolis, the city council approved a plan to start the process of dismantling the police department and rebuild a new model of public safety.
Now, I've had time to reflect on what's happening, and I feel like it's very fitting that these protests began in the days leading up to Pentecost, a time when the disciples of Christ were emboldened by the Holy Spirit to go forth and spread the good news. Yes, these protesters, seeking truth and justice, have found courage and hope enough to call out unto the Lord, their protest, a prayer of lament. Every time we attend Mass, we reflect on the Psalms, and nearly 70% of those Psalms are Psalms of lament. I mean, the wording is uncanny. From my youth, I have suffered and been close to death. I have borne your terrors and am in despair. Your wrath has swept over me. Your terrors have destroyed me. All day long, they surround me like a flood. They have completely engulfed me. You have taken from me my friend and neighbor. Darkness is my closest friend. That was verses 15 through 18 of Psalm 88. And they feel like they were written for this moment. So what are we supposed to do? Well, there's four things that we can do. First, we need to listen. We need to listen to our brothers and sisters in Christ. Why are they calling out? What is their pain? What is their experience? What is their struggle? Now is not the time to question those experiences or offer whatabouts or buts. Just listen. Then we must pray. And not an easy prayer for an end to injustice or for peace, but a deep prayer that yearns for healing within our own hearts. We must take what we heard when we were listening and ask that we hear and see through the ears and eyes of Christ. We must pray for patience and understanding, and again pray for trusting God's providence when we lack that understanding. We pray for truth and justice and for courage that we can act on those truths and bring forth justice. And we must pray for those in leadership and positions of power, that they be good stewards of that authority and serve those whom they have sworn to serve. Next, we need to learn. Yes, we understand that racism is an evil, but we must localize. What is the legacy of racism in our church? What is the legacy of racism where you live? How has it affected where Black people can live? What jobs they could get? What schools they could attend? What food they could buy? How has the local government sought to rectify some of these wrongs? Have they sought to rectify these wrongs? And where do our local leaders stand in the midst of this? And finally, we need to act. We act through protest. We act through dialogue, through prayer. We act by supporting the disenfranchised. And we act through voting. The irony is, the biggest change we can have is voting at a local level, and next to nobody does it. But this is where it counts. This is where we can make the biggest change in our local governance, in our police stations, in the policies that affect our community. These protests are bringing eyes to this conversation in a big way. Let's not lose this momentum and allow the possibility for change to slip away. In the description box below, I have links to articles and videos that help bring to light the truths of racism in the Catholic Church in Texas and in Houston. I also included conversations with religious to learn how to pray for an examination of racism in one's own lives and for forgiveness and healing for those who've experienced it. Make sure you're registered to vote. Know when your local elections are. If you live in Houston, those are July 14th. If you're a Catholic, make sure to read the USCCB Catholic Voting Guide. It doesn't tell you who to vote for, but it does help you think through many topics that should inform your vote. This is a moment where we can take a step forward for justice, for an end to police brutality and systemic racism, and where we can live our true calling to treat each other with the dignity of a human person and love each other as brothers and sisters in Christ.